Hello guys, so I've cast a really interesting replay from Total War League season. I actually don't know what season it is, maybe 5, between Wolf from Cell, I didn't even know this clan was alive, but whatever, and Hacker Beck, so Bakcha against Macedon. Bakcha is much stronger than Macedon. Bakcha, I would say, even counters Mastodon, and Bakcha has a disgusting build, disgustingly overpowered build, and it's kind of, how to say it, to try hard of a build. Well, every build with more than 4 horse archers is disgusting, but he also has elephants, so he also has pikes, so if there are any infantry in late game and he doesn't have the elephants, he can use the pikes to kill them, if he can time it properly, of course. Torque swords, Syrian archers will do well against any skirmishers in the game, so they can deal with skirmishers. They can also waste a lot of the enemy ammo, because they have 40 armor and 50 health, so they're kind of like the ultimate anti-skirmish unit. Even if they won't win, they'll waste enough of the enemy ammunition, so it will be worth it. But yeah, this is just disgusting build. The Macedon build, to be honest, it's not good against Bakcha. It's just too heavy on the skirmishers and calf. So he has no real answer to the horse archers, except for a couple of Tarantins, which will be pretty much useless if Wolf plays well with the horse archers. I have no idea why he goes so closely, so he just gives the Rodians free shots, so this is a mistake. He should be pressuring, and he should attack with the horse archers on both flanks, and in the same time advance his main army and try to focus the Rhodians and the Cretans with the Syrians, and then on the flanks with the horse archers. And because he'll be shooting from the flanks, the Rhodians will melt, or even from the rear. Sure, Macedon could support with the Tarantins or the Cretans, but then the Syrians will trade Tyranacy with the Rhodians. The problem is that Macedon is kinda in the forest, so shouldn't fire the center, more like the flanks. And he's wasting ammo. Why is he shooting on the militia hoplites? It just, yeah, very bad target. Why is he shooting at the mid-shield with 55 armor? And not at the Thracian warriors, at the Thessalian calf. Now he's shooting on Thracians. But yeah, basically this build is bad because everything here is kinda vulnerable to horse archers and to skirmishers. The Thessalian calf get well, not destroyed, but they lose pretty hard to Bakchan Nova Horse. So kind of too heavy on the Thessalians as well. If it was me, I would have went with some maybe 2 Earth Spears, 4 Thunder Slingers, maybe 3 Tarantins, and then I actually don't know. I probably wouldn't have went with Macedon in the first place against Bakcha, because it would be a really annoying game. It would have been the same if I was playing as Macedon, just with a build more suited to counter horse archers. But still, Bakcha can do pretty much whatever he wants, because Macedon doesn't have any good units to counter horse archers. Maybe if he went with five Tarantins or something. That might have worked. But yeah, as you can see, the horse archers can do whatever they want. And Macedon can do nothing to stop them. And there aren't enough armored units to use them as meat shields. So yeah, the Tarantines will get tracked by the missiles, the Thracians, the general, the skirmishers might lose men even if they just get charged. So it's just the militia hoplites, and for some reason, yeah, Wolf is playing this so bad. I mean, it's kind of, I guess, mean to say that, but why the hell is he shooting the militia hoplites? And from the front, not even from the back, he's shooting them from the front. Maybe he didn't disable fart wheel, which, by the way, you should always disable fart wheel, because you're wasting ammo. 7 losses here, and that's probably 3 or 4 volleys wasted. And why are the Torque Swords here? Why are they alone? And the only support are horse archers, which can't go into melee. Oh, nice sandwich here. Well, a bit too late, but would have been nice if he caught these annoying as fuck horse archers. And why is the main army not moving? Yeah, I've seen him doing this in a lot of battles. He just forgets about the main army, just doesn't move them at all. And only micros the horse archers, and the funny thing is that he kinda mismicros the horse archers, and he's controlling only the horse archers. It's a bit strange, but it's not this. Yeah, and why are the Torque Swords here? Look at the minimap, just look at the minimap. One unit here alone, one unit here completely alone. If it was me, I would have just charged them with the Thessians and then charged them with the Thracians, and this unit is gone. Sure, might have taken some loss from the horse archers, but would have lost a lot of men to the horse archers anyways. And I also don't understand why he's using the horse archers so aggressively, and only the horse archers, because he's wasting so much ammo. Horse archers are kind of overpowered in late game, because then if you lose your calf, you can't do shit about them, especially if you don't have any skirmishers. And he's not even using heavy shot, and he continues to shoot at the militia hoplites. Why? I don't get it. I really don't. Macedon is doing a lot of mistakes with the Thessians as well. Like, why does he cycle charge the Torx swords with the Thessalians when there are 4 horse archers there? It's just a bait. That's probably why he's using these Torx swords by themselves, to try to bait the calf into charging them and then use the horse archers to kill them. And he still shoots at the militia plates. Why? Somebody just tell me why. Why are you shooting the militia plates? They're just meat shields, they can't do shit. At least shoot at the Thracians, they'll do some damage, but the hoplites? Really? Look at their massive fucking shields. Yeah, it's a bit weird. And still, Bakshir doesn't advance. This build should destroy the Macedon's build. And at the moment, that's not really happening. And yeah, because the Macedonian skirmishers are not being pressed from the Bactrian skirmishers, the Macedonian player can just turn around and shoot at the horse archers. So the horse archers already lost 7 men. And these horse archers are not even doing anything. He's just resting, very tired. Okay. Well, at least this is nice for Bactria. Tessarians are being wasted. Maybe he's trying to waste some ammo. Yeah, he's definitely trying to waste the ammo of the horse archers. And he's kind of successful in doing so. So this is not not really a bad play from Macedon, as it would seem. Because he has to waste the ammo of the horse archers one way or another. And he's really lucky that the horse archers wasted so much fucking ammo on the militia hoplites. Yeah, he's trying to do the same here. That wasn't too successful, but it's fine. He'll try to sandwich. But why use only calf? Yeah, he shouldn't be using only calf, because the Torx horse will get a lot of kills on this Tessalian calf, and he'll need the Tessalian calf later to recharge the pikes, to kill the Syrian archers. Yeah, this is a mistake in my opinion. He should be using at least militia hoplites. It would be at best to use Thracian warriors. Even this with 70 men will be good enough to at least tie the Torx swords, so they won't throw their pillar. Because you can see how many dead Tessian calf are lying on the ground. And the Torx horse already got a chevron from this, so this is not a good engagement. This is just wasting the Tessalian calf. So, yeah. Kinda sad to see the Tessalians dying so much, but. He got rid of the Torx horse, so that's something. But this is a Pyrrhic victory. Yeah, this is definitely could have gone better for Macedon. Just 5 left, so this unit is practically dead. Half unit here, half unit here. So it doesn't really look good for Macedon. This Tarantine is pretty much worthless. Don't tell me you try to snipe. It's 11 men, why are you wasting ammo on that unit? Yeah, 3 volleys. So, 3 volleys and 11 men. They're no threat to you. why? Really don't understand. And still not engaging with his main army, not engaging with this part. So let's fast forward. Finally, holy shit. Engaging his main army after like 7 minutes or something. Yeah, you can see that the Rhodians are dying to the horse archers. And just imagine the Bakshian player would actually use his main army to do a pincer maneuver on the Rhodian Singers. So the Singer archers shoot from the front, the horse archers shoot from the back. And what happens is that Rhodian Slingers die in 5 seconds. Because for Singers, I don't really know why, but if they're being shot from the unshielded flank, or even worse, from the back, they'll drop like flies. It doesn't matter if the Slinger is elite or not. Well, probably matters a bit because of the health, but Balearics, Rhodians, whatever, they just die so fast. So this unit is probably out of ammo. A bit some micro here from Macedon player. So the Horse Archers got a lot of kills here. Well, actually not a lot, just like 4. Yeah, I think this is a win for the Macedonian player. If the horse archers are out of ammo, just don't engage them unless there is no cavalry near the foot skirmishers, and even then do a quick charge and then instantly retreat, because you're losing a bounce of power for nothing, for doing some hit points. I guess for doing some hit point damage, but it's still bad. And yeah, Bakshi is not even focus firing. Very slow with the calf. So Macedon is actually doing pretty well in the skirmish engagement. The Syrian archers are tired because he used precision shot. I never really use the precision shot unless I'm trying to snipe some heavy infantry and I need them to die faster than usual. Then I'm going to use precision shot. The Cretans here, very nice. Oh, flaming shot. Yeah, I don't like flaming shot because it's just 16 missile damage, and let's see how much AP. 1 AP. 1 AP. So yeah, I guess if he was lucky, the elephants might have trampled some live pikes or some senior archers. But yeah, I usually don't use flaming shot at all, because standard or heavy shot will make them run amok. Even though it will be a bit slower, it will do some damage to the elephants. And forgot about the flaming shot, so a bit wasted. Yeah, a bit wasted ammo. The horse archers are probably out of ammo at this point. Actually, they still have some, which is surprising. Again, stop shooting on the militia complex, damn it. Oh, I'm getting a bit triggered. Yeah, the Syrian archers are training quite well. Of course, it's 2v1, but yeah, the important thing is to waste ammo. Why are the elephants engaging? What? So, if Macedon just focus fire with these four skirmishers. Oh, he decided to retreat, so never mind. Because Bakche was no position to push, he activated the phalanx. So there are no infantry units to force the engagement. So Muslim could have just engaged the infantry and sniped the elephant in 20 to maybe 30 seconds. No, that's a bit too much. But yeah, you got the point. So Rhodians, damn, 100 kills. This is bad. Yeah, the Rhodians getting charred by pikes. But yeah, I don't think this withdrawal is good, because he could have killed the elephants with the skirmishers pretty easily. Oof. Oof. Yeah. That's not good. Big micro mistake from Macedon. Chasing the horse archers with General Y. Could have charged the Torx horse with the Thessalians and then charge the pikes. So that's a missed opportunity. Here, the Torx swords will destroy the militia hoplites, of course, but this is a bad engagement because of the Thracians and some of these Thessalians. And why are the Rhodians there? He probably forgot about them. And now this is bad. Because Macedon surrendered the forest, so now his skirmishers won't be as effective as before. So the Thessalians are dead. Now, yeah, I don't think he should. Wait, what? Are horse archers really going to charge into Thracian warriors? Yes, they are. Why? And he blocked his own unit, so yeah. This was a very bad play from Magcha. So the Torque Swords, this is another bad play, because if you can see, he's kinda exposing his unshielded flank, so these Rodians can focus the Torque Swords, these Cretans, these Rodians maybe not, these Cretans are dying, so it's fine. But yeah, I don't know why he's charging in like that. Yeah, as you can see, the Torque Swords will get focused by skirmishers and then recharged by the Thracian warriors. So this is very bad for the Torque Swords. The pikes are not doing anything. The scale torques are not doing anything. Wait, what? The pikes here are in phalanx, but Wolf charged the pikes in phalanx and didn't activate his own. That's okay. Guess he has to work on his micro. The elephant's charging into the general. The general will easily retreat. Still nice kills though. But yeah, the general won't die here. He'll lose probably 20 to 30 men. Yeah. So the elephants are still alive, which is a very big problem. The Thracians are kind of bugged out, so he needs to cycle them. Yeah, the Torque Swords here got wasted. Lave Pikes got wasted because of lack of support. Synergers are going into melee under mistake. These archers still have ammo, so these ones should also still have ammo. These ones don't. So, if you... I guess this was bad micro as well. Maybe he was trying to snipe some of the skirmishers or general. This is kind of a pull through here. Yeah, whatever. Let's see. So Torque Swords against Thracian Warriors. The Thracian Warriors might win this. Okay. Second. Okay, so the Indian armored elephants are charging the Thracian Warriors. Interesting. Yeah, the elephants will destroy the Thracian warriors. So let's see, this pike is destroying this pike because this pike wasn't in phalanx. Yeah, as I said, the Thracian warriors, they actually destroyed the Torque Swords because the Torque Swords were pretty depleted and without Pila they're just fresh meat for the Thracian warriors. The armored elephants did a lot of damage. And now, yeah, Bakchi almost got this. He just needs to be a bit careful. See, skill torques 51, leap packs 118. Okay, so this pike is dead. The general charging in. This is a bit premature. Because the general might die here, and if the general dies, this unit will die, this unit will die, and this unit will die. And he will have no units to kill the elephants with. So the elephants will kill the Cretans. Advance at speed. Move in. Yep. Is there any other unit which can damage the elephants? Maybe the pikes. Treasure wars will get destroyed. So battle rhythm, stampede, they're exhausted, so he needs to use the second wind. Wait, what? Why didn't he kill them? What? What the fuck? Why didn't he kill them? Now he might actually lose this. Imagine that. Okay, there I'm back. Oh, look at this. Look at this. Line up, man. The great beast of war charging us. Line up. Pikes down. Come on, man. You can do this. Your sons of Macedon. Yes. One down. You can do this, man. Look, our allies are helping us out. You can win this battle, proud sons of Macedon. For Macedon. Oh, it's probably Macedon, but yeah, it's probably Macedon because it's Macedon in ancient Greek. Oh, just in Greek. Yeah, the elephants are dead. The Thracians charging in. The pikes are way too slow to line up, so the pikes might be dead. Any calf remaining? No, I think the general will bite the dust. But I don't think he's dead yet. Yeah, I don't think he's dead. The pikes need to line up. But the elephants are dead. There is only one elephant remaining. So levy pikes. Yeah, Skeletorks will die. The levy pikes will try to do something, but I don't think they will. So yeah, this is over. Yeah, this was a throw after a throw after a throw for Bakshia. And very questionable plays from Bakshia. Yeah, as I said, this build should absolutely destroy the Macedonian build, because the Macedonian build is hard countered by this one. So the only reason why Bakshia lost is because, well, first off, he literally trolled. I mean, having one archer on the battlefield and not even routing it. Although if it was me, I would have made sure it was shattered. And then going to charge pikes, it was just one of the biggest throws I have ever seen. But yeah, Beck just played far better than Wolf. That's just a fact, which was clearly seen. But yeah, 7 horse archers against Macedon, then 3 Cytherians, 4 Torax, and an elephant. This is tryhard as fuck. Holy shit. Beck got a very, let's say, unorthodox build, because usually with Macedon, you get some Thracian warriors, you get some Torax horse, you get some cheap slingers, maybe with 1 Rodian for late game. Then companion calf general versus Bakshia, maybe some 2 arrow spears in case Bakshia brings an elephant, which yeah, he did. Although I wouldn't have brought an elephant personally. If I was playing as Bakshia against Macedon, actually, let me not see and go. Let me show you. So Macedon and Bakshia. So if I was playing with Bakshia, probably get a Bakshian Royal Calf. four Tor swords, some faction human, maybe some levy pikes, maybe not even levy pikes, maybe some eastern slingers for the city and horse archers. Waterfronts. Okay, let's do it again. Maybe even four Bakchan human. Four singers. And now let's see. So 5:30. Then I need 10. I could get one, one Siren Archer. If I was playing as Bakcha, this is what I would have brought, most likely. I might have decided to go a bit meme, because this is decent build, pretty competitive build, but I might have decided to bring a couple of healing cataphracts. So, or just one, and then I don't know, two archers, something like this. But this is a lot weaker build than what I had. But yeah, this is what I probably would have brought against Macedon. And as Macedon, Team Companion Cav is pretty much a must. Either that, no, shield bears are great tanks, but they probably won't kill shit. Raw Peltas dies to Skirmen Calf, which is basically Bakchia. Foot companions just suck, so yeah, either Companion Calf or shield bear. Then some Torque Swords, maybe three, and then three Thracians. I don't know about pikes, because Bakchia will probably bring pikes, maybe some slingers, then some Thessalians. I probably would have brought some Thracian calf because they're cheaper, but with these rules where, you know, horse archers aren't limited to four, it might be better to bring Tarantines. And then we have 1200 left. Might bring two Cretans. But then we have. Well, we don't have a lot of pikes. Yeah. Well, not pikes, but infantry. So might bring either two arrows. Might bring two pikes. But I think two arrows are pretty decent, maybe just three. And then .380. Oof. This is a bit harder than I thought. Okay, zero. Yeah, this is, I think, a decent build. Although I don't know if it's good or not. So, two Tor Spears will do very nice against the Elephant. The archers have 125 range, but they'll die to the Syrians in 2 seconds, so it's kinda risky. 4 Shock Calf, 3 Tarantines, then Slingers to just waste enemy missiles. The Torx just for the, I guess, reliable infantry. The Thracians against Bakchia, though I'm not sure of the Thracians. They did well in the battle I casted, but this probably only because the Bakchian player allowed that to happen. So I'm kinda not sure. If I bring 3 Agri Onions, it might be... might be bad, so... let's see... maybe some pikes. And one more... one more Tuer Spear. This also might work. And it's probably better than the build Backhead. So, 3 Tarantines to try to basically waste the Horse Archer ammo. These guys to waste the Syrian Archer ammo or the Singer's ammo. These to kind of contend with the enemy Torque Swords. These to counter elephants or any Bakchian calf your opponent might take. And these Levy Pikes to support the Torque Swords. And the Thessalians maybe to get to the missiles, maybe to recharge the infantry, maybe to contend with the Bakchian Cav. But again, Thessalian Cav are not really good against Bakchia, because the Bakchian Nova Horse are just that good. They're amazing. They're just amazing. 95 armor and 90 health. These guys have 90 health as well, but they're shock, so they can't really stay in combat. And all that Bakchia needs to do is get some Mitchell, for example, the Bakchian human, throw a pillar, kill like 10 of the Thessalians, then charge in the Bakchian Nova Horse, and the Thessalians are dead. But yeah, there are also different builds which you could go with. You could go with some Shield Bearers, because they're tanky as fuck. Might go with Thracian Warriors. Might not even bring the Thessalians, but maybe some Citizen Calf and even some Aspis Companion. Might pick the Thracian Calf. But I think you need to have some tanky infantry options, because otherwise Bakchia can... yeah, Bakchia could bring as many Horse Archers and Foot Skirmishers as he would like. This is why I don't think this matchup is particularly good for Macedon. It's actually very, very bad. Because, for example, imagine you face 20 Horse Archers. What the fuck do you do against Bakchia? You can't do shit. Even against 10 Horse Archers, you can't do shit with Macedon. At most spam Tor Spears, but they're not great. I mean, only 50 health and 50 morale. That's not really good. But yeah, with some balance rules and really limiting rules, that is, like for same max for Horse Archers, max one elephant or something, then this matchup becomes relatively balanced. But with these rules, it's kind of miracle that Beck won with such bad odds. But yeah, a very nice victory, so congrats to Beck. It's kind of, well, I don't know if it's inspiring, but I really feel good that he beat Bakchia with such kind of shit faction. Although Macedon is definitely one of my favorite factions, but yeah, it's just not a good faction, let's be honest here. But yeah, thank you guys for watching, and see you in the next video. Bye bye.